So, I'll be real. I used to tune out whenever I heard yet another pitch about some AI-powered workflow tool. You know exactly what I'm talking about, flashy promises, but the reality ends up being twice as complicated as just doing the thing yourself. But Claude Code's hooks kept popping up on forums, Anthropic's surprisingly candid docs, and even those genuinely helpful engineering blogs. And here's what grabbed me. Hooks aren't another gimmicky automation layer. They're more like having a teammate quietly watching your back, catching those dumb mistakes before you push, handling the boring, repetitive tasks, and freeing you up to actually enjoy building apps again. If you're a solo iOS dev, you get it. You're wearing every hat: designer, coder, tester, even the person convincing yourself at 2 a.m. that no, you don't need to rewrite that onboarding flow again. It's exhausting and yeah, sometimes lonely. So let's dig into how Claude Code Hooks. It could honestly make your indie Swift dev life a bit easier. Just real quick, I'm Daniel. I've been in the iOS trenches for about 8 years, mostly freelancing, shipping apps for clients, and figuring things out as I go. But since DubDub25, I've jumped fully into solo indie dev, started building openly, and yeah, still working out this whole personal brand thing. But we can chat more about that another time. All right, let's kick off with the one I really wish existed when I first started, the Claude.md file. You know those notes you always promise yourself you'll write, the rad me, but for my brain, but somehow never do? Yeah, this is exactly that, but made specifically for your AI teammate. Here's how simple it is. You just drop a file called claude.md in your repo and throw whatever you want inside it, your messy scripts, that random bash command you always forget, your personal Swift lint exceptions, or those weird touch this and it breaks reminders. It doesn't need to be neat. It's literally just for you and Claude. Why even bother? Because, and let's be real for a second, you will forget. You'll forget why you wrote some quirky script, or which command kicks off your Firebase emulator, or why your asset pipeline is held together by duct tape and hope. And when you inevitably step away from a project for a month or three, you'll thank your past self for finally taking decent notes. The real magic, the hook, is that Claude reads this file every time you start a session, jumping between client work in the morning and your own app at night. Claude's already caught up, changed machines, wiped your dev environment, or stayed up way too late debugging again. Claude still remembers your quirks, so you don't have to. Here's how I personally use it. I keep a global Claude.md for general Swift iOS stuff, always use structs. How I set up SwiftUI previews, my go-to Firebase starter snippets. Then each project has its own smaller Claude.md filled with the weird project-specific details, those tiny fixes that took 2 hours the first time around. When I ask Claude for help, it blends both together. Honestly, it feels like my past self finally learned to take notes. One more cool trick, you can actually tell Claude mid-session to add a quick reminder to claude.md about resetting mock data after test runs. Would this matter if you're a single app dev who never switches projects? Probably not. But if you're the type of solo dev who hops between gigs or likes to experiment and then revisit your own work weeks later, this little hook is pure gold. Look, every indie dev I know has their own secret stash of scripts they trust way more than random Stack Overflow snippets. You've probably got a bash command to clear build caches, a shell script that dumps test data into Firestore, or maybe even some sketchy Python tool that generates placeholder images. Over time, these hacks become crucial parts of your workflow, quirky but essential. Most AI tools just kind of ignore this messy reality. Claude Code, on the other hand, fully embraces it with something called custom tooling hooks. Basically, you tell Claude about your scripts in your claude.md file, just the basics, like what it does, any flags or options and how to run it. Then when you say, Claude, rebuild all my mock data and clear the Swift build cache, it actually runs those commands for you. And the kicker, it does it safely. Speaking of safety, Claude won't go rogue and start randomly deleting files. You control permissions, trust a script fully, you set it to always allow. Riskier ones? Claude politely asks you every single time, doing something potentially sketchy like bulk editing 100 files at once. Fire up a dev container and let Claude safely go wild inside there. This hook has genuinely streamlined some of my most tedious indie dev rituals. Stuff like running Swift lint across the project, auto-generating release notes from my commit history, or batch resizing screenshots for every possible app store dimension. Sure, I could do all this manually or script it myself, but honestly, I never remember the exact commands. Now, Claude just handles it, logs everything clearly, double checks when it's unsure, and never judges when I inevitably forget a flag. If your projects are super tiny, this might feel like overkill, but once your app has multiple moving parts, or you're switching daily between client work and your personal projects, having Claude actually running your custom workflows instead of just watching from the sidelines is a game changer. So, all right, this might be the most underrated part of Claude's whole system. It's super simple, but if you're used to solo dev life, you know, constantly winging it and hoping nothing blows up, this workflow is quietly revolutionary. Here's how it feels in practice. Instead of tossing code at Claude and saying, just fix it, you slow down and split each task into clear phases: explore, plan, code, review. Got a tricky Swift UI refactor? First, ask Claude to just look at the code, like that messy onboarding manager or the never quite right QRS scan history view, and explain what it's actually doing: dependencies, logic flow, tricky edge cases. No coding yet, just understanding. Next step, you ask for a plan. How could we add pro features here without wrecking my free tier? Only after you and Claude agree on this plan do you let it start writing code. And when the code lands, don't stop there. Let Claude review it, double check commit messages, make sure the logic's solid, or catch those dumb mistakes you're always making at midnight. Honestly, I used to think this approach was way too corporate for my indie life. Now, it's exactly how I avoid shipping late night disasters and blaming future me the next morning. The real magic here is the separation of thinking and doing. Claude doesn't write code until you explicitly say go, and it won't commit anything without your thumbs up. It's kind of like having a chill junior dev waiting patiently for your approval. No reckless commits, no random edits, just calm, intentional progress. Seriously, if you pick just one hook to try, make it this one, it instantly transforms you from solo coder hacking away into something that actually feels like a focused mini product team. Okay, if you've ever thought, I wish I could clone myself and have one me fixing bugs, one me doing UI, and one me figuring out how to ship this thing, this hook is for you. The multi-agent hook, sometimes called sub-agents or parallel sessions, lets you spin up multiple Claude windows, each one focused on a totally different part of your project. So if you're knee-deep in a feature sprint, one session can be refactoring your navigation, another can be reviewing all your Swift UI accessibility labels, and a third can be running tests or prepping your release notes. How does this help? Context switching is the enemy of flow. When you try to do everything in one window, or let's be honest, one brain, it gets noisy fast. Multiple sessions mean you keep each workflow clean, like having a different Slack channel for each topic. Jump between them as needed. Your mental RAM stays way less clogged. When I was prepping my latest update, I had one Claude session reviewing my new QR heatmap UI, one double-checking widget logic, and one just running bash scripts for cleaning up build artifacts. It felt a little wild at first, but by the end, I got more done in one evening than I usually do in a weekend. If you never do big, multi-part releases, you might not need this every day, but for indie devs who ship a lot or who are juggling side projects and freelance at the same time, this is a next level, I have a team now hack. Now for the automation nerds, guilty. The headless hook is Claude's way of running in batch mode, no chat window, just CLI commands, and output you can script or plug into. Here's why this is cool for solo devs. All those annoying, repetitive chores you have to do before every release, running tests, linting code, double checking for missing localizations, sanity checking your commit messages, whatever. You can make Claude do it in the background every time you push. No more did I forget to dread. The best part, you can script this into your CI pipeline or just run it from terminal, like scan my last 10 commits for anything dumb, double check that my widget views follow the right naming pattern, and flag anything that looks risky. I've caught more oops bugs this way than I care to admit, usually at 1 a.m., right before I almost shipped a broken build. For non-automation folks, this might feel like overkill, but the first time it saves you from shipping something dumb to the App Store, you'll never look back. Let's end with something deceptively simple, slash commands and custom prompts. Every dev has stuff they do again and again. Add accessibility labels to all buttons, write a SwiftUI preview for this view, test this data model with empty input and weird Unicode. With hooks, you can turn these into your own personal commands. Store them in slash commands, add parameters if you need, and now you've got your own library of rituals. What's the point? Less decision fatigue, fewer repetitive mistakes, and more time for the fun, creative stuff. If I'm honest, this has become my how did I ever work without it hook. I've got slash commands for accessibility checks, snapshot test setup, localizations, you name it. Is it magic? Number, but is it exactly the kind of boring, non-glamorous automation that keeps indie devs from losing their minds? 100%. If I'm being real, the most life-changing hook for me is explore, plan, code, commit. It forces me out of cowboy coder mode and into a rhythm that feels like having a tiny, calm team looking out for me. I don't need all the bells and whistles, but this one shift makes solo work feel way less lonely, way less scattered, and way more sustainable. My advice? Don't try every hook at once. Pick one, probably Claude.md or the Explore Plan Loop, and just try it for your next little project. See how it feels. Iterate, adjust. Don't stress about getting it perfect. Solo devs don't have to be alone, and they definitely don't have to do everything the hard way. AI can be an actual teammate, not a magic box, not a hype train, just another set of hands on your indie project. So yeah, that's the deep dive. Not just what Claude hooks are, but how they can actually make solo dev life a little smoother, a little less chaotic, maybe even fun again. If you've got your own hooks, rituals, or weird automations you swear by, I'd love to hear about them in the comments. Or if you're just starting out and something here sparked an idea, ask away. I try to respond to every message. And hey, if this was helpful, feel free to like, subscribe, or send it to another indie dev who's juggling too many roles and could use a teammate. Until next time, keep crafting, stay curious, and don't forget, you don't have to do it all the hard way. Peace.